Okay, guys, today I am making gumbo. So the first thing that I want to do is get my celery, green bell pepper, and onion, and I'm going to chop it up really thoroughly. This is going to make the trinity that is going to go in the roux and the base of our gumbo. I'm also going to take the beef smoked sausage, and I'm going to slice it into half moon shapes. I'm trying to clean up as I go because usually I don't, but you know, we'll see what happens. I'm also going to have chicken, shrimp, and crab in the gumbo. So in the back pot back there on the stove, I actually have the chicken thighs and drumsticks that are cooking in chicken stock, celery, onions, and some seasonings because I want the stock to be really rich. I'm also deshelling the shrimp right here. I don't like to have the shells in my gumbo. It's just unnecessary. So I'm getting my little seasonings together that are going to go in the gumbo, stirring up the stock. Now it's time to make the roux. So I'm going to get my heavy cast iron skillet, Dutch oven, and I'm going to heat the oil. So you want to have one part oil and one part flour, or you know, whatever fat you're using instead of oil. I'm just using vegetable oil. So while the roux is browning, I'm going to take that chicken from the stew. I've strained it and I'm just getting it off of the bone and getting rid of the extra fat and extra skin. So it's getting to a good peanut butter color now. I want it darker though. I like a dark gumbo. I don't want a light gumbo. So I put the chicken back into the pot along with the stock. I went ahead and once that roux got nice and dark, I went ahead and added the trinity to it and then sauteed that a bit. Put the chicken stock in there, the sausage now that it's been cooked down, the shrimp, the chicken. I think I said that already. I kind of did this a little out of order in the video, but you get it. So put the crab legs in there, put the shrimp in there, it'll cook down. Just give it about 15 minutes and then your gumbo is done. If you want the full recipe with very detailed instructions and with the proper measurements and everything, then you can find that in my cookbook, Classy Based. I'm serving this over rice, it's really good. Definitely should have took the bay leaves out, but whatever, we can pick around. I was so hungry at this point and this gumbo was absolutely amazing. Look at that chicken. The chicken is so tender, the sausage is in there, the shrimp, the crab legs. Oh, I just love gumbo. It's perfect for the winter time. Made it for a couple of friends, put some filet on there. The filet will thicken it up. And it just gives it that extra that you know for gumbo. And that's my gumbo. Look at it. Hope you guys enjoy.